I wanted an action cam ever since I heard of a GoPro. The hype was unbearable on all platforms. So, in 2020, when most of us were busy making music, I got myself a GoPro Max. It had all the promises attached to it. And as a biker, I was sure that I won't miss out on anything while on trips or on weekend rides. So this was a single device to capture all your motorcycling adventures. Camera unboxing. Icons on the box explain all of the features quite well. Open the box and you realize that there is no extra accessory apart from the two adhesive mounts and a slider attachment for the camera. Lens cover, lens safety cover, and an average carry pouch is all you get. I was expecting a bit more, as this is the most expensive camera in the GoPro lineup. Video and interface. The camera is easy to operate, easy to understand, and I could control it through my phone during rides. Although 30 frames per second is just not enough for 360 slow-mo vids, and hero style video did not have 4K capabilities. All in all, 1080p is all you get. Although the camera shoots in 5.6K as advertised, reframing the footage gets it back to 1080p maximum resolution. I don't prefer using voice commands as I find them unreliable on motorcycle. Does it capture it all? Oh yeah, you bet it does. I mean everything around you. And it produces those rad looking tiny planet shots too. And it's super stable at whatever speed you're riding at. Unlike a Hero, Max proves to be much more versatile for a rider like me. Battery life. Shooting 360 comes at a price. Since a lot can be captured with this camera, I feel that a larger battery could have helped for sure. Maximum battery drain happens while shooting 360 time lapses. In about 60 minutes of shooting, the camera completely drains itself. So either you plan your shoots in advance or carry more than two batteries fully charged. The mobile app. The mobile app is a boon. It can edit, reframe, freeze frame, zoom in, out, tiny planet, and lets you play with most of the features of this device. One can edit almost like a pro on this app. So for instant consumption, it's quite fast, but making professional edits, one may require it to convert .360 videos either into ProRes or Cineform. And this is where everything falls nose down. Coming to the problem at hand. Although advertised as universally compatible product on the portal, it does not behave like one. If you're a Mac user, go all out. The interface in Mac gives you every feature this camera advertises, with the finesse of an ice skater. But if you are a Windows user, then GoPro has already taken you for a 360 ride. In order to convert .360 files to an editable format, you need a software called GoPro Max Converter, which will produce equi-rectangular video file in a 5.6K resolution. These videos can then be edited with the help of GoPro Reframe plugin in Adobe Premiere Pro. And much to my surprise, GoPro Exporter has a lot to be finished. The frustrating part is that in Windows, you can only convert, unlike a plethora of options available in Mac. Adding to this is an unstable software. It can't be ruled out that GoPro is biased towards Mac. Hence, you should only buy this camera if you're a Mac user. Else, wait for GoPro to solve, debug these issues and make it more versatile for Windows too. And additionally, stay tuned for my next video where I finally fix GoPro Exporter from not crashing in Windows. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. And see me struggle through these shoots, write edits and voice of such videos. Adios for now.